Hello everyone, my name is Greg and I dev stuff. Welcome to episode 30 of the tactics game in Unity. So we need to introduce a way to select the team which will participate in the upcoming battle. So there are multiple ways we can do it. In games like Battletech, you select your team before the mission starts. Or in games like Fire Emblem, you select your team after the mission is loaded and you place characters on the map. Each approach has its pros and cons, and should be used based on what kind of game are you making. In this tutorial, we will do the latter one. When we select the mission starts and should allow us to select characters to place on the scene. Okay, and to do that, we need to mark up the space where you can place someone. Actually, it gets really uncomfortable managing all of this. To introduce a new system, let's separate our new system into a new scene, so it's isolated and easier to manage. So unload our combat essential scene and add a new scene called place character scene, so we can introduce character placement in isolation. Move camera. Okay, first we need to introduce markers, which will allocate spaces to place a character. Make a capsule and color it pink. Good. This object will be used to mark the node in which we can place our character. Because our marker will be working with grid, add grid object component. To be able to reference the target grid, we need to place our placement node to the combat stage. Reference the target grid. Let's test this. Good, as you can see, our placement markers get placed into the node and calculate their position on the grid. Turn off the character turn to fix the error. Okay, now we want to make it possible to place character from the list of available characters into the map. Let's make an empty object, call it Unit Placement Manager. So we have a scriptable object, which carry data about the squad. We will be using the squad, so make a serialized field for squad data, and we will be reading the squad which will participate in the combat from the scriptable object. Good, select the marker on the scene and create another new component called placeable unit node. Let's prefab our node marker and place the second one. Good. Open placeable unit node. Here we want to make slot for the character who is placed in those nodes. And we need to store the list of all available nodes to place our characters in on the unit placement manager. So first cache the unit placement manager. Because it exists on a separate scene, we have to use find object of type to cache the reference. Then on start, go and create a new method called addMe, and pass this node as a parameter. Inside newly created method, we need to store the reference to the passed node into the list. So this list will contain all the nodes on the scene, where our player can place a character. Now we need to process the input from the player to give player an ability to place the character on the nodes. Create a new method called processInput, which will be called from the update. We need to read the mouse input, so cache the reference to the mouse input by using getComponent. Add the mouse input to the same object, which have the unit placement manager. Let's make a test. If we click on the node where we can place someone, we want to post some message into debug. Because we need to read the state of the grid object in the placeable unit node, cache the reference to the grid object. This will allow us to simply search through the list of all nodes. And if there is a node in the same position as our mouse, we will post a debug message. We have an error. If I click on position, it works fine. But if I move around, we are getting this new reference. This is happening because in the mouse input we are posting position on the screen into text object, but on this new scene we don't have a text for it. So we should not make our mouse input component be responsible for reporting on the screen what is being selected. Let's separate it. So we should pull out this process out of this component. This will make our mouse input component be responsible for less things. And when you don't need to post the position of your mouse on the screen, you just don't use the mouse position on screen component. So simply move all the logic behind the report of the current position on the screen into the new component. Good, as you can see, if I click on the placeable nodes, it will report that we are clicking on the node, and if I click anywhere else, nothing will happen. Good. Let's make it so we can place a character from the squad on the scene by clicking on the nodes for characters. We have to generate the characters from the squad as game objects, which we will control in battle. So we need to create reference for prefabs, for character prefab and for character model prefab. We need a list to store the list of character objects. On the start, creating call a new method called init. Inside this new method, we will cycle through all the characters in the squad, so we will be able to create objects of each character. To do this, call and create a new method called initCharacter. Pass the data of the character who we are creating. Inside, instantiate character game object. And then make a new character model. Parent the model to the character object. Remember, character object is carrying all the information and controllers for the character, while model is just that, visual representation of the character. Let's test this. Assign references. And let's launch the game. You can see how our game creates two new characters, because there is two characters in the squad. There is errors. Our character is trying to work with the grid, and character turn, which isn't present on our scene, exclusively created for placing the characters. So let's just turn them off for now. Good, it works. Now in the unit placement manager, we want to make it possible to place spawned characters into the nodes. Inside process unit, if the place node exists and it is empty, colon create new method place character. Pass the node we have selected and first character in the character object list. Inside newly created method, move character into the position of the node. And set character as being placed into this node. We need to add the newly created character into the list of characters. Nullify the position of prefabs. Remove character which you just placed from the list. And let's test this. So now if I click on the placeable node, you will be able to place spawned characters. Good, this is just an outline of the system. In the next episode, we will expand upon it and introduce transition into the gameplay. Good. This is it for this episode. If you have any questions or any ideas about code, please leave your comments below. If you want to support me, link in the description. Special thank you to this old HD and Stormbreaker 9000 for their generous support. With best regards, see you in the next episode.